An elite club of high-tech startups is bucking the current economic trend and thriving in this tough economy even. But less than a decade after the dot-com crash, are these Silicon Valley tycoons heading down an all-too-familiar road? Joining me now, the founder and managing partner of WNB Private Client Services, Mickey Cargile. Thank you very much for talking to us. You know, if you have a few billion dollars, there's really a lot of money to be made for these investors looking for the new Facebook out there. The question is, you know, it's less than a decade after the dot-com bust, which taught Wall Street and Silicon Valley investors that what goes up must come down. So the question are investments in these tech startups headed toward another big bust, do you think?
Well, Julie, it doesn't really matter if we're talking about flipping houses or internet service companies. We just continue to make the same mistakes, and the bubble and bust is just a core element of capitalism. We just have to accept that. It's fueled by greed. And in this case, we actually do have something. There's great economy to the internet. You know, we could take things that make a penny per click and actually, you know, spread that out throughout the economy, and it turns out to be a lot of money. So if Google and companies like this want to give these smart young people $1 billion to see what they can create, I think that's good for them. You know, we have exported so much of our manufacturing that it's good to actually have an industry here in our country. But for most of your viewers as investors, this is not an appropriate investment.
No.
You know, there's so much risk involved. Venture capital firms expect most of these ventures to fail. You know, maybe as many as 80% of them. And all you have to do is just think back 20 years, and you know, the hot technology of that day was AOL.
Okay, but let's talk about the hot technology of today. You've got Facebook, obviously, Twitter being a really big one right now, and more of these wealthy people are viewing these investing techniques as a hobby, really. How do you think this is going to increase the competition among new startups?
Well, obviously, that there will be it brings more money into the industry is the bottom line to it. And especially when you get a little bit of hype started, like this movie that came out about Facebook. I think that's what really got things excited. There's a lack of opportunity for investment right now. You know, your alternatives are, you know, the slow growth economy at 2.5% and zero interest rates. So people start reaching for returns. But you really have to pay attention to the risk involved. And just realize, let these venture capital firms make some money and, you know, find a company that actually has a good business plan and some steady revenues.
Do you think that there is going to be another Facebook out there? I know a lot of investors are pretty much looking for the next Facebook in its infancy. Or do you think, you know, supply will not keep up with demand? And is it possible that this technology bubble might actually not burst for quite some time, considering social media right now is the way of the future?
Mm-hmm. Well, I do expect that, you know, 10 years from now, we may not even know the name Facebook. And that's just how technology works. Something will leapfrog something else, and it just creates its own market. You know, it may go the way of the CB radio. But actually, there are some opportunities out there. You know, a few firms will survive. Even if we look back to the carnage of 2000, you know, we do have Amazon.com. That little search engine named Google has survived. But we forget about the companies like Toys.com.
Right. All right. Thank you very much for talking to us. We appreciate it, sir.
My pleasure, Julie. Thank you.
Greg.
All right. This is an unbelievable.